My name is Dr. Charles Shelton. My age is 51, and I'm from Huntington, West Virginia, originally. When I first got sick, I actually knew prior to May of 2011 that something was going on. I was feeling fatigued and just not feeling right. In mid-May of 2011, I went in to have an elective surgery, and the surgery went well. And while I was in recovery, I went into what's called complete heart block, which essentially is where the electrical system of the heart short circuits. And in August of 2011, Johns Hopkins did a number of studies, including an endomyocardial biopsy, basically a biopsy of the heart, where they go inside the heart and take a little snippet. And that showed all scar tissue, but they still thought it most likely was cardiac sarcoidosis. And at my last visit up there in October of 2011, they told me, my cardiologist and the transplant cardiologist told me there's nothing more that they could do, and they said to come back to Kentucky and to get on the transplant list, that I needed a new heart. The other issue that drew me to UK was the staff of cardiologists, the treatment team. And Dr. Rajagopalan collaborated with my cardiologists at Johns Hopkins, which was very good because there was continuity of care. And my son, we were able to talk about the whole situation openly. And my son told me, my oldest son said, "Dad, it would be horrible if you were to die." And that got me motivated. And so that was about 3 weeks after I initially got sick. And so I got myself prepared and got myself ready for this journey, for what was ahead. And on December 26th, the morning, I got word that they felt that they had a heart. I had mixed emotions. I guess I was concerned to some degree about the surgery, but yet was thankful that I had a chance at living and at being able to continue to be with my family. And Dr. Ramaya opened me up and essentially took my old heart out and coordinated that perfectly with Dr. Hoop's arrival. Dr. Hoop's landed at Bluegrass Field. They immediately brought the heart here. He came in, scrubbed in, and put the heart in. And that evening, I remember waking up with the endotracheal tube in place, and they took the tube out. And I remember specifically at that point in time just how I could breathe. I remember just taking a deep breath in and just feeling how well and how good it was to breathe. And that was because I had a brand new heart, a brand new pump in there that was pumping blood to my lungs and to the rest of my body. It was amazing to have that feeling, just being able to breathe in. And I knew that that I was, I had this new heart, and I knew that it was a sensation that I'll never forget. With a heart transplant, the first year is really the most critical time in the recovery. Dr. Rajagopalan put me into cardiac rehab 1 month after the surgery, and I stayed in cardiac rehab. That's going in to UK cardiac rehab 3 times a week, and I did that for 6 months. The other issue for me is the fact that this sarcoidosis that attacked my heart can come back. And so we do have to watch closely and monitor myself for that. The The thing at UK is that everything's patient-centered. The number of times that staff would come in and ask, how are you doing, do you need anything, is phenomenal. I would recommend UK to any family member. And the reason is, it's a state-of-the-art facility. The transplant program is growing. They have the ability there to perform procedures and to do things that only the top institutes in the country are doing. I guess what's amazing and surprising is the fact that I'm alive and well, and that I'm here, and that I have my life back.